This morning, one in five hospitals in the U.S. is facing a staffing shortage, the latest brutal statistic from the front lines in the war against COVID.
We may be superheroes, but we are not superhuman.
In Knoxville, Iowa, these nurses never expected this. The protective suits, the grueling shifts, the sealed hallway.
I've been with a couple nurses crying. You get to the end of your shift and we've done all we've done. So just the consoling of them and saying, you're a great nurse, you're doing all you can, we're gonna make it through. And, you know, it's hard.
Hospital workers created this makeshift COVID unit over the summer, hoping they never have to use it. But things have changed over the last few weeks.
They have no ICU here. Their first and only ventilator is on order.
You're right on the cusp of things going from ugly to horrible, and that's where they're living right now.
From small towns to big cities, more drastic measures.
We can turn areas that aren't hospital areas into hospital areas, but if we don't have the people to take care of the patients, it doesn't matter.
North Dakota is allowing infected but asymptomatic workers to treat COVID patients.
We're pretty much at our breaking points, and so now if we contract the virus, we have to continue to work.
60 Air Force nurses are now headed to North Dakota as backup. In Utah, where nearly 85% of ICU beds are full, some hospitals are preparing to delay elective surgeries. At Nebraska Medicine, staff are using handmade signs to beg the public to wear a mask.
Patients who then are coming in for a heart attack, for a stroke, we might not have the capacity to take care of that patient.
Resources stretch thin across the country.
One of my biggest fears is that we will have to make very difficult decisions about who gets the best quality care.
The emotional and the physical stress, it's exhausting, absolutely exhausting. I don't know how we are getting through it.
For many small communities, the pandemic has taken not just an emotional toll, but a financial one. Across the country, at least 17 rural hospitals have closed in 2020.